Tag, you're it. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Chris, and this is my channel, We Love Comics, and I got a good idea for a tag video that will help the comic book community. So I would love for the people to participate, and if you're tagged, hopefully you'll make a video, and if you do, place the link in the comment section of this very video, so this way other people may get the opportunity to see and subscribe to your channel. If you're not tagged and you'd still like to do this particular video, by all means, please do. And again, you can place the link in the comment section. I don't mind helping other channels out. So this is one that's going to help especially the newer people in comic book collecting. And this tag is Help the Community Grow Tag. And what I want people to do is pick five comics. You could do more if you want, but a minimum of five comics that you think are potentially having value in the future, explain why, and keep them under like a $50 to $60 range. So five or more comics that you think are potential comics worth getting that are still incredibly reasonable to get price-wise. So I picked five people to tag. If you know any of these people or you're subscribed to them, leave a comment in one of their videos to let them know they've been tagged in case they just don't see this. And if you're new to this channel, hit the little bell icon so you'll get notifications of videos when I post them. So here are the five channels that I will tag. And it goes as followed in no particular order. We have Alex the Comic Hoarder. We have Pop Fun to Play. Comic Trips, Comic Holics Channel, I like that one, and Mr. White Gloves himself, Splash Page Comics. So if you're on this list, you are hereby summoned to have a tag video of your own. If you know any of these people, please leave messages. And if you want to do one, you are more than welcome to. So before I start, don't forget to wait until the end so you could see my surprise subscriber shout out. And I also appreciate all the feedback on the new outro that I've done on my videos. That will be from all the videos from now on. So if you haven't seen it, wait until the end to check it out. Let me know your opinion. Pretty much everybody said they liked it. So, all right, without further ado, my five books that are going to be under $50 and I think do have potential. So let's start with the one that's probably least likely, but still for the price worth getting. All right, this right here, and let me so you can see a better picture, is the Savage She-Hulk issue number one. This came out in the late 1970s, so this is around the end of the Bronze Age, beginning of the Copper Age. This is the first appearance of the She-Hulk. Now, the movie rights are kind of up in the air who really owns them. It's a little complicated. But the way companies are starting to kind of make deals and work with each other, you never know when something like this could be happening. And with the amount of female superhero characters that are coming out these days, this has a potential to happen somewhere down the line. Now, in my opinion, I don't think she'll get her own movie, but one of the things I suggested is, if they do make an agreement, and it doesn't guarantee they will, she could end up in a possible Marvel TV show, like, for example, making an appearance on Daredevil. Because remember, she is a lawyer, and she has been spotted on several occasions in the Hell's Kitchen area. So the fact that, you know, Daredevil is based on his law firm, and she is a lawyer herself, you never know. So it's something that is a potential. There are no guarantees, but this is a book nowadays you could pick up between $20 and $40, depending on the condition. When I bought this years ago, as you could see here, I paid $29.99. So it's got potential, but again, like I said, there are no guarantees. Same with this next one. This is Marvel Spotlight issue number 32. This is the first appearance and partial origin of the Amazing Spider-Woman. Well, not really Amazing Spider-Woman, but Spider-Woman. And again, with the same concept of, you know, the fact that a lot of female characters are coming out these days. Now, I believe Sony owns the rights to this. I could be wrong, so if I am, please let me know. But again, now that Marvel and Sony are working together, who knows if she might make an appearance at some point. So this is, again, another book. And again, this is about late Bronze Age. This is another book that has potential because of the fact that you can get them pretty cheap. Again, this is around a $30 to about $60 book, depending on the grade. Obviously, 9.8s are going to fetch higher prices, but I'm talking like mid-range to about very fine. You can get for around $30 to $40. And the show, I got this at $32.99. So if she ends up in a movie or a TV show, again, has potential. All right, this one is based on the fact that if you cannot afford the first appearance, sometimes the second appearance is what people will gravitate to next. So this is one I would definitely recommend because you could get this one pretty cheap. This is Amazing Spider-Man issue number 135, and that is the second appearance of the Punisher. Now, if you've seen, thanks to the success of the first series of The Punisher, and they have confirmed a season two, the books, especially Amazing Spider-Man number 129, has been getting up there now. You're talking an 8.0 goes for about $1,100 on eBay. Raw copies in low grades are selling over $400 these days, and you're talking good, very good range. So that could be out of a lot of people's price ranges. So if you're one of those people that just may not have the financial ability to buy the first appearance, the second appearance is the next best bet, and it's a dramatic price difference. You can get this book in mid-grade to about fine grade between $40 and $60 range. You know, again, high grades are going to cost a lot more money, but this is definitely an affordable book. And to show you, I mean, I have several copies. I got this for, let me show the price, $35. And I have several copies of this. So as the Punisher's value keeps rising, the value of his other appearances are going to keep going up. So if you can't afford his first appearance, that's the next best thing. All right, this one, I mean, this is one I recommended back in my old days on my channels. I bought these years ago. But these are still affordable books. And this is Shazam, issue number one. Now, this isn't his first appearance, but it is his first appearance since the Golden Age. And this is definitely a great book to have, especially with the fact that they have confirmed that the Shazam movie is still coming out. So this book has a lot of potential. Now, it's gone up since I recommended it back in the days of my old channel. But you could still get this book for around $35 to $50 range. And when I was getting these years ago, because the best time to get a book is not when everybody wants it, because the prices are going to double and triple. It's when nobody wants it. So when I was telling people to get this back in 2015, 2014, no one was buying them. And I was picking them up for all day for under $20. Like you could see this one, I paid $19.35. And you could see this is in pretty good grade. Now these are harder to get in higher grade because there's a lot of white in here, so they can get dirty over time. But still, a mid-range copy of this will still get you around $40, somewhere around there, which I think potentially is still a good price, because most people outside of the comic book community, or people that are barely in it, tend to buy these books when they see the first teaser trailer and people start talking about it. But that's when that book is going to be even higher in price, and that's the worst time to be buying a book. So you still have time to get this book, but it has increased since the last few years ago when I was letting people know about this book. All right, so the last one of my five books that have a lot of potential, here we go. This is, again, the case of if you cannot afford the first appearance, this is the next best thing. And this is Marvel Spotlight on the Moon Knight, issue number 28. So this is, again, a Bronze Age book. A lot of these are Bronze Age books. A lot of them are starting to get out there because a lot of people can't afford the Golden Age and Silver Age keys anymore, so they're moving on to the next level. And then probably in another 10 years from now, you're going to see more and more Copper Age books going up. But as you saw with the Black Panther movie, the Jungle Action, I think Jungle Action 28, forgive me if I'm wrong, But the first appearance of him on a solo and the Black Panther issue number one, which again was a book I told people to get years ago. I got like 5 or 6 copies years ago. You could see that that book 3 years ago you could have purchased for around $20 to $30 is now a $60 or $70 comic. This is again a comic that has potential. Now, there are no indication that he's going to be in a movie or a TV show, so this is obviously pure speculation, but so many people ask for this character. I don't think he would be good in a movie, but he would definitely be, for example, a great character on The Punisher or Daredevil or some other Marvel TV show, maybe even on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I think that would be the least likely, but I think, like The Punisher, if he appeared on a TV show, the fan response would be so amazing that he would probably end up getting his own series. And if he even makes one appearance on a show, I mean, the first appearance, which is Werewolf by Night, it's skyrocketing now, and there are no speculations about him being in a movie or TV show. No rumors. I mean, you know, generic rumors, but nothing confirmed. And those prices are going through the roof. And, of course, that's issue number 32, in case you didn't know about it. Again, that book is a very expensive book, even in low grade. You can get this book, again, between the $30 and $45 range. And, again, I bought these years ago, back in 2014, 2015, and I paid $21.50, which, at this point, you may find a sleeper or two out there to get that price around the $30, $25, $30 range. And if he gets a TV show or a movie debut, which I don't think, but I think it's going to be a TV show if he gets one, people are going to go after this book like there's no tomorrow. I think this book would double and go higher. So that's it. Those are my 5. I got plenty of others. If people like this, I may do it again. So these are the books that I would say, again, under the $50, under the $60 range, have a lot of potential to end up getting you a good return if you get them while they're inexpensive and before, you know, they get their TV shows and movies. And again, there are no guarantees, so you take the chance. And the good thing is, if you take a chance and you're not spending a lot of money and you enjoy reading the comic, then you win regardless. So that's it. So I want to thank you guys for watching. Again, I want to post these up. So guys, if you're subscribed to any of these 5 channels, go send them a message, let them know they've been tagged. If you are not familiar with any of these channels, type the names up in the search bar, go check out their videos, and subscribe to their channels. So, again, I don't mind helping out other channels. So, even if for some reason you don't like me or my channel, if you still want to do the tag video, I will allow you to post your link in the comment section, because this is all about helping other people in the community. Because especially the newer people, if we get more and more people investing in comics and collecting comics and having fun with comics and learning about ones they may not have, you know, known about, that just helps us all win. So hopefully you'll participate in the tag video. Hopefully you'll give it a thumbs up. Hopefully you'll subscribe. And there's a lot of hope going on. So that's about it. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to wait until the end to see who's the surprise subscriber shout-out. Thanks for watching, and don't forget, it's not you, it's not I, it's We Love Comics. So thanks for watching. I'll see you next video. And yeah, back in the days, Spider-Woman shot laser beams.